So, chapter one, why do we need to focus on well-being? Well, what conventional wisdom tells us and what neuroscience shows us are often conflicting. That results in leaving many kind of busy leaders unsure of how to create that well-being culture within their team, which will help their people to thrive and bloom whilst enhancing that organizational success. And in today's dynamic and kind of demanding environment, prioritizing employee well-being is no longer a mere option, but an essential strategy for organizational success. And a culture of well-being not only enhances employee morale and productivity and engagement, but it also contributes to a more positive and resilient workforce. There are over 8 billion people on the earth. And neuroscience has shown us that no two brains are the same. Therefore, it's hardly surprising that no one else thinks in the same way as you. But what is surprising is the number of leaders who spend their time wondering why their staff don't think the same as they do, let alone why they approach their work in a different way. We're all unique with different strengths and abilities, which also means that we need different things to allow us to grow and thrive at work. So, developing a workplace culture where everyone can thrive is actually a skill. And that skill very much still needs to be developed, practiced, and mastered because it is so vital in today's workplaces. Yes, we still need to have a business model that allows for monitoring, measuring, compliance. However, the real strength in a business is the potential of the people. To make the business better due to their energy and the ability to collaborate. Get this right as a leader, and your business will be bursting with ideas from your people. You'll see exponential growth on the back of their passion for the work. Get this wrong as a leader, and you spend all your time trying to force compliance and structure, but the work of leading will be so much harder. And it's up to leaders to set the course towards success. The HP Workplace Relationship Index, I'll just let it kind of come up on screen. You can read it for yourself rather than go through it all and read it out. But you can see there, only 27% of people have a healthy relationship with their workplace. 29% experience a sense of purpose and empowerment in their workplace. There is a global well-being and mental health crisis. I'm sure everybody, nobody would dispute that. But it's going to require a big shift in organizations. A change in mindset and culture is needed. Well-being programs, healthy eating days, gym memberships are not enough on their own to solve for the well-being and burnout. The focus has got to now be on culture. For sustainable high performance, trust, empathy, psychological safety must be perceived as high by both employees and leaders. Well-being has got to be at the core of the organizational culture. And in the 2022 Future Pulse report, some of the kind of findings from that report was that the impact of increased levels of stress and burnout that we're now seeing in the workplace on a single employee resulted in them being two times more likely to disconnect and disengage, 60% less able to focus, 32% less productive.